It's a shame that the lid is missing. That seems to be a common problem here at the Goodwill. Look at this. Look. Right, well, it is the Monday before Christmas and we are here in Middletown, Maryland, and we are sitting outside the Goodwill. We're gonna go in here and see what we can find to buy and flip for a profit, but we are also shopping today for Spirit Week. Yes, we've done this before on this channel. Juliet has Spirit Week. I am not a fan of Spirit Week. I don't know any parent who is a fan of Spirit Week. It's just such a struggle. It stresses me out. I don't know why. But tomorrow she has to wear red and green, and I don't think we own anything red and green. So now I have to plan, and I have to find something that's red and green. And then on Wednesday, she has to dress up like a Bible character, and I don't think that we have any clothes. We don't have any Bible character outfits at our house. I don't know why, we just don't. I mean, I could look through the closet, but I don't think I'll find anything. And then Thursday's the last day of school this week before Christmas, and she just has to wear Christmas accessories. So maybe like a Christmas scarf, an ugly Christmas sweater, something. But we're shopping for Spirit Week in addition to finding stuff to buy and flip for a profit today. So enough jibber jabber. Let's head in and see what we can find. Here we go.
What? 49. I mean, that's not a terrible price for that. I could sell that for 80 something in my booth. I'll buy that. I told myself walking in here today that I was not going to buy any Christmas. And the first thing I pick up in the door, ceramic tree. Oh, shoot. This does not want to go down in there. I don't know. I think there's like glue residue in there and it's like not having it. Okay, so I figure we'll look through the clothing last. And I am going to peek through the Christmas for my own personal decor. You guys know I'm working on my mantle. Well, you don't know that, but I am still currently at this moment in time working on my mantle, and I don't have any stocking holders because we've never had a fireplace, so I've never really needed them. Now we actually have a mantle and we have a need for them, but those are all mismatched. I don't know, you know, I kind of wish that I had held on to the Pier 1 stocking holders that I found last year, but I sold those. Those would have been really nice. Noel, they spelled out. Of course, now there's five of us, not including Walter, because, oh, look. Walter's living with his grandparents now. Let's see. Oh, they're adorable. I like those. I mean, there are only four on this one's. I like what they did there, though. I'm not mad at it. A nice big mirror. That one actually probably would have matched my mantle, and I don't know if I really want to match my mantle. I'm pretty happy with the one that I got, even though it's kind of like not my typical decor choice. It's more of a chic-y shabby, dare I say. I know that phrase is trademarked. Well, that one's not bad either. That one's really big though. $14.49 on that. It's looking a little sparse over here in the hard goods today. What just happened? I guess it's not attached. All right. Good thing that wasn't glass. I'm just gonna slide that over there. I wanna check out these in the back. Love. I do kinda like those. Those are cute. I grabbed those for myself. I wonder if those are accurate though. Those would look cute in the kitchen. Grab those for my own kitchen. Here's some Pennsylvania redware. At least it looks like it anyway. 1990, 250 years. I don't know. kind of specific. I think I'm gonna leave that one behind. Ooh, we've got a fresh cart. That looks promising. Let's see what we can find here. Oh my gosh. What? 99 cents. You can barely even see the trees on those. I think those are, yeah, those are spode. Wow. Oh, I thought that was made from wood, but it's made from resin. Made it to look like wood. This is quite the decorative glass piece. It's very large, $8.50. These are still kicking around. I thought those would have been scooped up for as decorative pieces at least, because they are nice aesthetically, but they're still hanging around here. Those look like they went through the dishwasher a few times. That's a shame. It's plastic. Got mugs down here, but nothing's really jumping out at me. Here are some cow creamers. Looks like they're all a little bit different. And they're Worley Industries, Warren, Pennsylvania. $1.50 each. Yep, no problem. Sorry. Go ahead and move that. I think they're adorable. So I think I'll grab those since they're all different. $2.50 on those. Exceed Bone Clear by Keto Rich Pan. I do like the pattern on those, the floral pattern. What are these? Moose Country. I really love this canister. If I had to guess, I'd say it's, I don't know, I was gonna say Japan, but maybe not. It's a shame that the lid is missing. That seems to be a common problem here at the Goodwill. Look at this. Look. It's a missing lid conspiracy. Oh, goodness. All right. Well, we're almost done here. This is a smaller Goodwill, so sometimes it's pretty quick moving through here, and other times it's slow, but I can see the fish plates are still down there. I do love this colorful box, $4.49 on this. It's probably a souvenir piece from Central or South America. $1.49. It's just colorful. It's always the colors that catch my eye. And yeah, I think I'll grab that. It's not a huge money maker, but it's pretty. And we did all right. I didn't find a whole bunch, but a few good things. I have to browse through the baggies real quick just to make sure that nothing exciting here. Craft something. Oh, here's some paints. I just bought Juliet a bunch of paints that she's gonna see under the tree on Christmas. Those are kind of nice. Napkin rings. All right, I'm gonna go check out the artwork. Here's more Asian artwork. There's been so much of it lately. I'm just really curious where it's all coming from. I actually like these more than the ones that I picked up the other week. Much more. The one I got was black and white, and these are much more colorful. I think that's why I'm attracted to them. What do they say on the back? Nothing really on the back to go by. Yeah, I'm definitely much more attracted to these, but you know what? I'm not gonna take them with me. Not going to take them. Way too much artwork recently. Gosh, I just picked some of these up. I think it was a week or two ago from another Goodwill. What are these? Are these what I think these are? I think they are. I think that's why I'm excited for these. I think that these are old slate. Okay, so when I was a kid, we took a field trip to an old one-room schoolhouse, and we were given these like slate things just like this. And throughout the day, we did our work on these like pieces of slate. I think that's what this is. Look, this one, this says P.S. Stanball. Like, one kid signed his name on his slate thing. Oh my gosh, these are old. Those are the coolest thing. I'm going to put those in here because I think those are what I think they are. Right? Those are like 1800s, early 1900s. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. You can tell me what you think in the comments, but I think I'm right about that. See what else we're missing. Here's a modern one down here. This one's lame though. Save the date. That one's lame. I don't know why would you, I guess save the date makes sense, but like, let's donate this. Like, what are the chances that someone's gonna come in here and that date is gonna be relevant to them? Okay, well, I think those are the only ones that are here. What is that? What is that colorful thing back there? That's super colorful. Oh my gosh. I'm not buying artwork. Wait, no, maybe I am buying artwork. No, I'm not. Maybe I am. What is that? Besides super fun and colorful. And are those donkeys? Or are those llamas? What is happening? I love it so much. If I'm buying artwork, this is the one I'm buying. Okay, I'm gonna take it out and look at it. It's so super dusty. What is happening? Okay, I'm like, does he have a sword? Are they hunting? I don't think they're hunting. I think it's just like a fun festival or something. And there is a marking there. I don't know if that's a signature. It's just so colorful. It is $17.50. This is one I would probably sell and not hang on to, just because I have so much artwork. And last night I was hanging it and I'm like, you know, I think some of these pieces just don't fit, even though I love them. So I'm probably gonna start listing some of the artwork I've bought for my home just because they don't jive. And I think that this might be one that I would list. Okay. I think we might be in luck. I see a pair of green pants, but they might not be the right size. Let's see. Green pants for the win. No, size 6. She's nowhere near a size 6. All right, well, here is a shirt for Thursday. Selfies with Santa. There you go. All right, well, I picked her out a few red tops. Red. This one is a little bit big. This is a little bit big for her. It's 18-20. She's currently in 12, but I think sweatshirts are okay to be big. And this one is actually in French, 14 ands, but I'm assuming that's years. And she's not quite there yet either. So she can pick. I think this will be best for the Christmas day, which is Thursday. So we still need green pants, but I don't think we're gonna have any luck at this Goodwill. Fortunately, this is the first step of the day. And I still have 4 chances to find green pants today. Before we leave, I wanted to check this side of the Christmas shelf because I only went down the other side. You can see I'm carrying around the Christmas star. I eventually disassembled the Christmas tree and laid the painting over because it was too wide to fit through the rows. So I'm holding onto this so it doesn't get broken because that's the last thing I need. Here are some more stocking holders. I kind of just want them all uniform. Oh, here's one of those really long ones that I like, but it's just a single. Ooh. Oh, these shelves drive me nuts. All right, yeah, I don't really see any. I don't know. I think it might be something I have to buy new. So I might take a Target trip or something like that. What is this? Vicky Jean's Creations. Oh my gosh. I feel like that's more of an Easter thing, though. I wonder what this thing is supposed to be. It's kind of odd. Is that a Yule log? Oh, and this. Oh, this is fancy. Look at this. Wow, I guess this is the arts and crafts section right here. What size is that? I wonder if I could try that one on. Oh, I guess, well, maybe. Let's see. There's no size. Did I miss him on the bottom? Oh my gosh, I'm dropping stuff. It's falling apart. Size is probably under the sticker there, right? I think I'm going crazy. It's probably best I don't try it on. I gotta pick up that. Watch me pick up the flower, everybody. I'm filming it so that you know that I did it. Because I only do things that I film. There we go.
Okay, well, our total spend there at the Middletown Goodwill was $100, and I feel like we did really well with that ceramic tree right in the door. Very thrilled with that. I don't know yet if I'm going to hold on to it until next Christmas or if I'm going to list it up as a buy it now. I've only got a week until Christmas, so I don't think I'm going to be able to get it out in time. It's just a really hectic, crazy week for us. And so I'll probably end up holding on to it. But anyway, I am at the next Goodwill. We are at the Goodwill on Monocacy Boulevard, and we're gonna head in here and see what we can find to buy and flip for a profit. And maybe find some green pants. Here we go.
That's kind of fancy. Elm. 1983 is the date on that. Does that mean it's made out of elm? I don't know. She kind of has a weird face. I don't like her expression for $25. I do kind of like that. What is that? Northern Song Dynasty. Oh, that makes me so nervous sitting right there, but I'm going to leave it. So I've picked up two pieces. I grabbed this guy. This is a fused glass. You can actually see the two layers of glass and the fibers in between. It's actually pretty neat. And then this, which has cherries on it. I was kind of hoping I'd be able to find the other glasses that go with it, but no such luck. That's kind of neat. That's like, I don't know, like it's supposed to have an owl head. Looks like an owl body. I'm not really seeing much here today, so I'm probably not going to stick around very much. That looks like art pottery. $14.49 on that, though. Wow. Absolutely love this so much. It's $19.49, but it's missing the lid. Oh, I'm so tempted. But I think I'm going to leave it here. And they're actually organizing the shelves, so I told her I would put everything back the way she had it. She had it in nice straight lines. So there we go. This is neat. Sand Dollar. Luna Res. I've never heard of that before, but that's like a nice beach decor. Yeah, I'll pick that up. I really love the hot air balloons. You guys know I have a thing for hot air balloons. And I think that's pretty accurate. As far as temperature goes, I don't know though. It has a lot of scuffing on the plastic. And then this here, Warren Kimball. That cat is so cute. Let's see what's inside. All right, I think I'll take that with me as well. Cat box, made in China. Here are some horses, and I like that horse right there. I can't tell if it's a creamer or not. I don't know if there's a hole in the bottom. Oh, it's a shaker. It's a single shaker, though. Dream big. I don't know. I've had luck with the baggies here in the past, but recently, not so much. Seem to be my day. Ah, look at that beauty. That thing is gorgeous. It's such a shame that it's got the green oxidation there. And then in the back, there's two nice mid-century style lamps. The one has some wear on the design, but those are pretty nice. I'm not going to grab any lamps today. I'm saying that now with certainty. There's an ironing board if anyone needs one. What is that thing? That looks intense.
Okay, well, my total spend there at that Goodwill was right around $22. But I'm at the next Goodwill, and you guys are gonna have to wait for that video. And I will see all of you guys tomorrow. So long. I know it's nothing new, but it's so good to see you.